Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Vincent Gasa, Once Man Ponder. We apologize for the long absence. Actually, I've been having a lot of commitments, so we apologize, and we promise you that henceforth we'll have our videos as we normally have them, the usual frequency. Now, today we are going to examine a quote from myself. Today we are going to examine a quote from myself, and it goes thus: inappropriate representation, or its lack thereof, of a thing or concept neither negates it nor makes it inexistent. I'll take it all over again. Inappropriate representation, or its lack thereof, of a thing or concept neither negates it nor makes it inexistent. Now, what do I mean by this? When I talk of inappropriate representation, we are talking of explanation, elucidation upon a concept, an idea, or a fact. Let's take, for instance, this quote can be very, very, I don't know the word to use, delicate. Let me use the word delicate. Yeah, it's very delicate because it can create some sort of controversy. Now, let's take a controversial issue like abortion, for instance, and we notice that a lot of times we have debates about abortions. There are proponents for abortion and there are proponents against abortion. Now, take an example wherein you have a state which is considering legalizing or banning abortion. And now, they have two opposing sides who are going to debate upon this, and then maybe a panel of judges who are going to decide on whether or not to abolish it or to legalize it based on the arguments presented. Now, we'll notice that the truth is one side would have better arguments. It could be the side for it, it could be the side against it. Now, the fact that one side has a better argument, let's take for instance that the side that actually is arguing against it has an inadequate representation or a poor argument. The fact that they have a poor argument and that the judges decide to make it legalize abortion does not necessarily mean that they were wrong, or does not necessarily mean the idea was faulty. It's just that they weren't prepared enough to defend their point. That is what I'm trying to mean by inadequate representation. So the fact that a concept cannot be explained properly or properly broken down for the other person, for the next person to understand, does not necessarily mean that that concept is faulty, does not make it a bad idea or a bad thing, or does not make it inexistent. Another example that could fit with this quote really well is the idea of the existence of God. The fact that someone, for instance, cannot properly explain to you, and in explanation prove to you, logically speaking and without irrefutable fact, that there is a God somewhere, so much so that you come to understand and accept, does not mean that the concept is necessarily faulty, and or that it's not a bad concept, or that it's a God is inexistent. Now, the reason I say these quotes can create some sort of controversy is because on the other hand, it can be argued from both sides. Now, as I've used God, the fact that somebody cannot give a proper explanation against the existence of God does not mean that the person who did, or does not mean that God actually exists. Let me put it that way. So that's why I said it can be quite controversial, but this is just what I wanted to convey to us today. So thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, and please let us know your comments in the comment section, and your opinion really matters to us. What we really love you to do for us is that if you like the video, hit the like button, and please, as always, do share. Good night, ladies and gentlemen. See you next time on Ponder.